Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Pracha Eamranond, Chief Medical Officer at Doctorpedia, and today I have the pleasure of introducing my friend and colleague, Dr. Fabio Orozco. He is an Associate Professor of Orthopedic Surgery at Jefferson. He's also Director at AtlantiCare for Orthopedic Surgery, and it is a pleasure to have him here because he's, as you will see, a force to be reckoned with and has a lot of insights into healthcare in general, and particularly as it relates to knee and hip replacements. So Fabio, welcome to the show.
Oh, pleasure. It's a pleasure to be here with you.
So can you start off by telling our audience a bit about yourself and how did you get into the work that you're doing now?
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much for having me. It is an honor to be here in Doctorpedia. I believe that this is a tremendous source of information for patients and something that's making a real difference in the world. The reason why I started to get interested in orthopedics started very early in my life. And I love to put things back together. As orthopedic surgeons, we're able to fix things, and I love fixing people. I happened to be exposed to orthopedics very early and fall in love with it. I have done research for many decades now, and I love the ability to be able to fix people that are younger than older, and hip and knee replacements can make a tremendous difference on people's quality of life. Technology is something that just gives you that thrill of the happiness and be able to do a better job every time. And orthopedics has a lot of technology, and with robotics, which is what I do, you are more precise, you can do a better job, and it just continues to do better and better. And when you see that your intervention makes a difference on patients, that's when that energy and that ability to create a system that is cost effective, the ability to send patients home the same day after surgery, control pain and make a difference, that's what I love.
So Fabio, I've had the benefit of sitting, you know, where you are for the last 2 hours and listening to the videos you've produced, which are amazing. And you have so much energy, so much insight. I hope our audience gets to see some of these videos as it relates to all aspects of orthopedic care. So you mentioned technology. How do you see that technology is going to play a role in the future of healthcare in terms of joint health in particular?
That's a great question. You know, the ability to use technology is helping us to create a more cost-effective environment. And what I mean with that is, if you use technology like robotics, for instance, there is a lot of predictability. So you're able to do a big part of the surgery before you make an incision. That is less morbidity for the patient. That is less cost. That is less surgical time. That is less invasive surgery. You also can predict the implants sizes that you need. So you can perform surgery in smaller places like surgical centers that don't have the real estate to have a bunch of inventory. So you are able to be more cost effective, predicting what implant the patient needs. You are also able to have less trays in a surgical setting. Every tray that needs to be sterilized is a lot of money, is a lot of space, is a lot of work. If you can do surgery with less trays, with less equipment, and do it better, that's where technology is. So technology gives you also the ability to do a better job. And that should translate into implants that can last longer, less revision surgery for a health system, and more predictive value. So I think if you use technology properly, you are able to provide a more cost-effective medicine.
Right, and I've certainly noticed that in my practice, and when I refer my patients to orthopedic surgeons, I'm seeing now their entire experience has improved for a lot of reasons. Technology is one of them, and having them stay in the hospital less time, having them recover, having them have function in ways that they didn't have, I'd say, even several years ago, and certainly decades ago. So we're still in a pandemic. We've had various cycles depending on where you live and the circumstances you know, within your household. We're still thinking about how the pandemic is going to impact us in the future. So I'd be curious to hear your perspectives on how the pandemic has really impacted your practice and how do you think it's going to impact joint health in the future?
Yeah, absolutely. I think that, you know, there is something that we learn, and is that COVID is something that we're going to have to learn to live with. And COVID needs to learn how to live with us, and we're going to have to learn to live with COVID, kind of like MRSA or influenza or other type of bacteria and viruses that are all around us. So in orthopedics specifically, we had a difficult time for a period of time. Surgeries were postponed. Some surgeries were canceled. Some hospitals completely stopped doing elective surgery. And that was a difficult time for patients and for practices. Mm-hmm. Today, we have learned how to live with COVID. And today, we can provide a very safe environment. Everybody gets tested. Everybody's now getting vaccinated. We are very careful with any type of visiting, family members visiting the patients who stay in the hospital. And one of the big changes is that we are shifting even faster than what we thought to outpatient surgery. So those days of people staying in the hospital for 3-5 days and going to a rehab place, today people go home, and they go home the same day or the next day. And I think what people realize is that the length of stay has nothing to do with the quality of the care. You can have the best quality, the best technology, the best nurses, the best surgeons, the best doctors, and be home the next day or the same day with a beautiful job. So the length of how long you stay in the hospital has nothing to do with how good of a job your surgeon does or how good of care they take care of you.
So right, I mean, certainly I've seen that in my practice too. And the care after the hospitalization is key. You know, it doesn't make a difference whether you're in the United States or, you know, in Europe or anywhere else around the world. What is your sense of, if you've got the crystal ball, how would you say, again, going back to that technology piece you mentioned in the future, how do you think we can utilize technology better, you know, to really take care of patients, like the ones that go home faster, to be able to care for them? Because I think a lot of our viewers, including myself, always wonder, you know, what can we do to take care of ourselves better, including after, you know, surgery, when it used to be that we'd spend days in the hospital, right? And now we're looking for those resources to take care of ourselves, our loved ones, after we come out. What do you think are the major game changers?
I think one of the best game changers is that we have protocols, and many of our protocols in different parts of the United States and in different parts of the world are very similar. There are some variations, and there are some things that are applicable to some environments and not applicable to others. But having protocols that are based on research and that are based on trying to provide the best cost-effective medicine, I think are very important. So in surgery, you know, minimizing the dissection of tissues, being more gentle with the muscles, with the tendons, making smaller incisions, trying not to use narcotic medications, trying to maximize the patient health prior to surgery, stopping smoking, making sure the diabetes is under control, and working on education. That is where Doctorpedia can make a difference. Expectations for patients are based on education. And that's what we together, patients, doctors, nurses, anybody who's touching that patient can make a difference. Doctorpedia can make a difference on patients' education, and that can create better expectations. And I think that is one of the most important things that we can do with our video platform.
Thank you, Fabio. So it is an important point, you know, certainly that access to health information that's timely, that's accurate, to really combat the misinformation that's out there. We know there's a lot of it, particularly in regard to health care. And we need to look for ways in which we can educate our patients, educate each other. Time is running short, and I just want to see if you have any pearls of wisdom that you'd like to tell our audience, you know, a global audience, that's listening in to us today?
Absolutely. I would like to tell you that I'm very happy to see that you are looking at Doctorpedia. I can tell you that we are doing everything we can every day to provide the most accurate information that is important, that is relevant, that is up to date and non-biased. Thank you for looking at Doctorpedia.
Thank you, Fabio. Dr. Fabio Orozco, thanks to everyone for tuning in, and please stay safe out there.